Alrighty, guys. Now I can say it. Alrighty, guys, welcome back for another Team 5 Tactic video with the one and only Heaven. Only the goal of this video is to try and learn and understand. We're still brand new to the Reckoning Path, so we're trying to figure out what is the ideal class to go for and kind of learning what champions are what, you know, like what their different classes are, what they look like in the game, and how we can overall be better and getting comfortable with the different classes, learning. So that way, when it's time, we will start transitioning over and doing ranked gameplay, which I'm definitely excited to try to aim for gold. The highest I've ever been was silver, but I want to like really push myself and try to see if I can get ranked as gold. And if we surpass that, we surpass that, right? But if you haven't, make sure to subscribe to the channel so that way you will not miss another Teamfight Tactic video. All right, let's get going. I'm really curious. In the last video, I was talking about how my front line wasn't able to, it was only like two people do champions. So I think what I'm gonna do this round is try to be more frontline heavy and see if that makes a difference. And then I'm very curious if the opportunity presented itself, I want to do more with the Coven class. Morgana was amazing. LeBlanc seems amazing. And then I believe as Lissandra is also part of Coven. So I think it's those are the only three so far that I'm aware about: LeBlanc, Lissandra, and Morgana. So I'm very, very curious to see what we can do with them. So very curious to see like how that plays out. Sell a champion to get their items back. Yep, yep. Oh, that's a koi fish. That's actually really cute. Aww, koi. Is it Dowsy? Doozy? Sugar Crash Dango. Oh, that one's cute too. The Fae Hushtail is really cute. It reminds me of Eevee. That's why I like it. Hopefully, I can unlock a little legend and get a Hushtail. Like I said, look at it, like, oh, that's a Vulpix, that's not even an Eevee. I have a Vulpix plushie right next to me. I have a Glaceon plushie. I have no idea where it went. Okay, frontline heavy, guys, frontline heavy. So he was really good last round we play. So I wanna see how he does. And he's, so we're gonna, and we're, so, all right, let's mess around with Dawnbringers. That's gonna be pretty cool. And then, of course, here comes a Forgotten. I don't know, I like the Forgottens. They're gonna have a special place in my heart, always. Always! Okay. And then look. Look what's popping up, these Forgottens. I cannot. You're tempting me very. Oh, they're tempting me. Don't do it, Heaven. Because I'm like, he could be a frontliner, right? Right? And then, don't do it. Oh, okay. Nope, don't do it. We're supposed to be going Dawnbringer. Okay. Here we go, some Coven. Alright. Okay. I'm like really struggling. My heart hurts a little bit because I didn't get the any Forgottens. Are you okay? I was like, he's not a Forgotten, he's Abomination. That's right. Okay, so Dawnbringer. Night. I did say I'm gonna be frontline heavy, so we'll try it. That's a Juwani. Nice. Yo, he's insane frontline. Like, insane. Oh, here we go. And then there's a Dawnbringer, Kha'Zix. I'm undecided what I want to build so far. Undecided. Oh, she's an assassin? LeBlanc, okay. I see you. I definitely see you. It's insane. So I'm putting Kha'Zix over here because he's an assassin, and then LeBlanc. So what I'm hoping, they just have the one. Either they're AFK or they're just saving. But they don't have anyone on there. That's so really interesting. Maybe they're AFK by accident. But what I'm hoping is that I can have my assassins trap. So if they're, and also if they're doing their formation, left heavy or right heavy, I can still, oh, the golden spatula. But I think I want to, because of my team, I need like mana and rods. No one's going the, I was going to say, I was like, no one's going for the spatula. Imagine. All right. Is she a Dawnbringer? I think so. She is. So we have assassin. Damage, assassin. I said I was gonna go frontline heavy and I'm not! Okay. It's all 100% my bad. Okay, 100% my bad. What other Dawnbringers can I use that are frontline? I don't think there really are any. I just need Morgana. Oh, they have a Morgana. Wow. Assassins are definitely helping a lot. I think the only one that went down is Nidalee. I'm thinking I might have to do Aatrox. Cause I don't think there's any other Dawnbringers. What I also might do is throw this Giant's Belt on him as well if he's gonna solo Frenet. Here we go. And then... Because they're both redeemed. Yes. And then Soraka. And I think that's my full team. I don't think I'm going to need anyone else. So now, because I have pretty much my full team, so I have two frontliners, right? I have an official healer. And then I have another damage slash the coven leader. So I'll be able to fill completely do the full three coven, which is going to be pretty amazing. So I just need to focus on getting gold and abilities and just like focus on what I have. And I don't need anything else. So that's going to be cool. Okay, so now I can throw in... We're gonna throw in Morgana just because I want that coven. Wait, what are they doing to her? Oh, is she the coven leader? Are they making her the leader? Yeah, we definitely need another frontliner. He went down, but he held on. And I think having the two assassins is also going to help tremendously. Critical strike, magic resist. We'll do magic resist. And then, let me see. What's her ability? Magic. It's fine. We'll have LeBlanc buff her up a little bit. And then do that. I can't believe I was like, frontline heavy, And I have no frontline. I have one, let me not lie. And maybe I was like, my frontliner is going to be strong and heavy. I don't know. Oh, Karma, maybe. I still have these two as well. So it's not like I don't have a full team. It's just... I don't know. I just felt bad because I'm like, dang, homie's just holding it down for everyone. But that just means like the rest of my team has to come hard. Like, but from the looks of it, I'm not really seeing anyone else like go coven, so... Dope. We're doing too bad. We're not doing too shabby. We're not doing too shabby. Not too shabby at all. Okay. So where are the Don? So there's cousin. What's her name? Rel? I think. If I could, I'll probably get her. Oh man. Still locked up. You don't want her. Nope. You don't want her. You don't. Nope. You don't want her. You're a jerk face. Okay, well, I'll go ahead and get a giant spell. I couldn't get him! What is this game? Alright. They gave me Leeson. We don't need you right now, sir. Thank you for chilling, hanging out. Nautilus is ironclad. He's also a knight. I'm undecided who I want to throw in. Oh, they're probably just new. I'm learning how to play. Or AFK. And that's the thing with Teamfight Tactics. If you're AFK, a lot can happen. So I highly recommend not to. And the thing is with TFT, it's like, you know, you're like, each game is at least 30 to 40 minutes. Like, you ideally want it to be at least 30 to 40 minutes. Because that means you're doing a good job, you know? Oh, so that's how they do it. So they can pick anyone to be the coven leader, but because Nidalee was in between, she was. That's interesting. What a difference it makes having her as the coven leader. And ooh, that was a little too close for comfort. I didn't like that. I mean, no likey. I did not like that. We will put her gladly back here. Where was she? Right here? Right there? Right there. There we go. Power Nidalee up. That's fine. Okay, we're gonna throw in another front line. Tempted to just put him in, double him up, you know? But that works because he's going to be a two-star next round. So she's a coven leader. I'm glad they made her like really buff on here. Like, she does work. You know what I mean? Like, Nidalee does work. I like that. I absolutely love that. Some champions need, you know, some lovin's. So I'm glad she's getting that. Does he do damage or his ability? Oh, they're all ability. She does damage. Right? We'll increase her. Oh, Riven could probably be another, like, frontliner. So I don't know, if I had to pick between Karma and Riven, I probably would be leaning a little bit more toward Riven. Oh, I can't see. Come on, Nidalee. Come on, Nidalee. You're the coven leader for a reason. Let's go. Dude, she's doing awesome. Okay. Yeah. Is this Karma? That looks like Karma, yeah. Wait, what's her ability? Oh, so she has an AoE. What do you do? Oh, you stun? Girl, say less. That's all I had to see was that you stun. That's a GG's. Oh, wow. Who's that? Uter. Oh. They gotta take their back lane out. Oh, LeBlanc with the chain? I see you. Yo, LeBlanc. Oh my, I love this team. I love them. Okay. Oh, Kayle. That would be a good frontliner if she's a... Is she a Dawnbringer? No. Oh, it's another Karma. Okay, I need to look at items, to be honest. I think I'm going to get that. I want a rod. Oh, or not. Just kidding. JK, we're not getting that. Your bench is full. Who is that? Oh, Nunu. That works. Interesting. Oh, Dawnbringer too. That's probably why I couldn't find Gragas or Gargus, however you say his name. Yeah. Oh. Oh, that was so close. Nidalee, she was so close. Oh, boo. She did a fantastic job. I have to grab him when I see him, because now that I know, so the literally it's like Dawnbringer versus Dawnbringer. They're Dawnbringer, Renewer, and Brawler. We're just Dawnbringer with a dash of Assassin and Coven. Like, that's what we got going for us, guys. With our poor two tank, our two frontline. What is up with me doing that, man? Yes, it's time. Thank goodness. Okay, and then Nidalee will be the next one I work on. And then we'll either have to get Serac. Let me see, comms area and the enemy, current percent, Jillian. I don't know if I want Soraka then. Like, kind of looking at it. The coven has eyes. I think I'm gonna get rid of Soraka. Sadly. Alright, and then next round I'll be able to add the final piece, which is Riven, to the puzzle. Okay, so one more round and then we get Riven in this. Okay, I have to turn my chair. It's like getting serious, starting to get toward like late game. Nice. Okay. So, I think I'm gonna give Morgana this rod. Especially at four. Okay. Give it to Morgana. And then we'll hold on to that because I might be able to Guardian Angel it up later. And maybe give it to him. We'll see. Yeah, LeBlanc can take these tier threes down like it's nothing. It's actually quite insane. She's like definitely underrated. So, and she's like the Coven trio. I love, like, I absolutely think it's a phenomenal, just amazing. Diana, Nautilus. We'll leave Nautilus alone for right now. I didn't even see what Riven did. If Riven did anything, I was not paying attention. Yikes. All right, here's a rematch. Let's see. A lot going on. Yes. There we go. I didn't even watch Riven again. Oh my god. I'm so bad. What is this? Oh, there's a Guardian's Angel that I wanted but can't get. I don't know what those are. What is that? Like, I'll guess. Oh, I can't. Okay. Well, not anymore. Let's do a hedge tech. I don't know what those are. Those are brand new to me, so I'm good, you know? Ooh. Okay, so the heal cannot affect the holder. So we're gonna give that to Riven. And then I'm gonna snag this Garen just on the safe side, but from the looks of it, this is gonna determine how the rest of the game is gonna go. It's like really all about just like being able to penetrate in their line of defenses, so. The monstrosity. Oh, yikes. They whooped my butt. For sure. All right. So I'm thinking I may end up third. Second or third is where we're looking at. From sixth to second or third, we'll gladly take that. Look at Teemo. Teemo's cruelty. Teemo scatters 5 infernal souls around a random enemy. When an enemy nears an infernal soul or after 3 seconds, it explodes, dealing 140 magic damage to nearby enemies and reducing. I'm just gonna get him, but I'm not gonna use him. just because it's Teemo. Who did he like poop at? Who did he throw his poop to? He threw his poop to somebody. Yeah, this person's build is insane to me. That monstrosity. Yeah, what is this? Redeemed emblem. The holder gains the redeem trait. Oh, I see. So instead of doing spatula so much, you can just earn that. That makes it simpler. All right, so Nidalee is 3-starred up. Morgana on the bench is 2 stars. Lissandra, we can start working toward. Morgana. This is about to be 3-starred in not too long. I can give that to... Aw, we'll give it to Lissandra. She doesn't have anything. I'm just like, I don't know. Let's see. Okay, I'll get rid of Teemo because I don't need him. Come on, Nidalee, do some cleanup work. Do some cleanup work, Nidalee! Let's go! That's so awesome! Making her the Coven Queen, plus she's 3-tiered, man. Coven Leader, I'm sorry, but she is a queen, so that's fine. Hi, Merdigger's on here! He's a cute. Oh my god, look at that skin. He's the cutest. God King. That's what they are. No, it's gonna be a little bit. Oh, we're winning! Oh, they have him. No, he needs to die. No, he needs to die. He needs to die ASAP, man. That LeBlanc and Nidalee combo, they're scary, man. This team is really, really amazing. Like, this is a really, really amazing team. Who's this? Pantheon, go away. I mean, I technically can get rid of... I don't want to, though. I don't want to mess anything up, but... I mean, I have enough comfortability from the looks of how these matches are going to try around with the God King instead of the... instead of Nautilus. So, ooh, I want that. Or that. Frozen Heart. Oh, I could have gotten another Garen, huh? With a thing, ability attached. Whatever, man. All right, let's try this. And then. See how this goes. Oh, God. One off. Kidding me? Alright, let's see how Garen. I'm gonna watch Garen. Garen's right here. Let's track him. Yeah. The rest of my team does so much work that it really, like, he can go. Like, they do so much work. And then Morgana's now a 3-star. Like, this is late game, late game. Yeah, you can go. And then Sunfire Cape goes, and then you get that as well. Enjoy. That's insane. I'm just trying to see if any more of them show up or another Riven, but honestly, this is my team, and they're doing a really great job. Okay, I'm watching Garen again. He's annoying. Oh, good for targeting him. Yes, get him gone, get him gone! No, 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 no! Oh, wow! Wait, what? Oh, no, I was not paying attention. Yikes. Okay, so LeBlanc. Oh, so they're out. So, like I said, okay, I thought I was going to get third. I'm going to probably get second, but we'll see. If I can probably level some of them up, it might make it... it might help, but we'll see. I'm not good with adjusting formations, but I have enough wiggle room to do so. But I think I just want to power up LeBlanc a little bit more, just to be honest. Where is she? We'll give it to her instead. Blanc. LeBlanc. There we go. Garen. They're everywhere. They have so many people. It's so many. I can't even tell. Oh, is that a Kayle? Oh, ew. No wonder. Oh, oops. I did not want you. I was trying to get that Garen, but... Damn. Yep, guys. And this is where it starts kind of going to that point where it's like, all right, I take my L. But it's not really, it's not, okay, we got second place, like, compared to the last game. And we didn't even go tank heavy, like, frontline heavy, which is actually kind of funny. Because I was, oh, they got a Heimerdinger too? A 3-star? What is this person? Oh, it's these eggs? Whoa. It's those eggs, probably. That's insane. I kind of want to play around with that class next. Yeah, no, you definitely did a they did a phenomenal job. That's insane. That comeback was insane. But like I said, we did a really, really good job for not knowing what the what we're doing. I'm extremely proud. Very, very proud. So I think I maybe like one or two more battles and then that's it. See, look, okay, so look at, I want to look at their team. So they have two front lines. How many do they have on their team? 9? That's insane. That was crazy. That was insane. Oh, sun and moon. We got it. Wait, what? Oh, the sun and moon was that was from the last game. Okay, I'm not gonna argue. I will gladly take all these cool fireworks. I think that's cool. Oh wait, are they all like, they looked like, a lot of them look like birthstone colors, like kind of thing, you know? That's a lot of XP we earned in one game. All right, that's cool. So recapping on this, Coven is insane. LeBlanc, gotta have. Like her chains alone, just the work that she does, and she's an assassin, she's insane. Like LeBlanc was like tearing it up. I don't know how she did it, but LeBlanc was amazing. Nidalee, fantastic. Morgana was really good too, but I like, it was mainly LeBlanc that continued to catch my eye. Nidalee came through with a lot of cleanup work. Gragas, however you say his name, was holding it down. When I like, probably one of the best tanks on here so far. This is two games in, whatever, but holy moly, was he holding it down for the longest by himself. And then Riven did a good job. Like, it wasn't anything where I noticed 100% of what was going on with Riven. I was just really focused on like Gragas and making sure he was holding it down. And then LeBlanc just kept stealing my eyesight, just trying to see what she's doing. Garen was pretty cool. I didn't even look at what Godlike did, but yeah, Kha'Zix did a good job too. But holy moly, these three right here, man, they did a phenomenal job holding it down. It's like insane to me. Oh, I haven't opened, I received that yet, so that's fine. Alrighty guys, so that's gonna wrap this video up. Like I said, we are grinding Team Fight Tactics. We have the Reckoning Pass, and I'm really excited because now we'll be able to have like all these cool things. Like, can we customize it now? Where do we go to customize? If I play. So yeah, so we got the little legend that comes with it. When we have now all these really cool booms that are pretty gorgeous. That's pretty. Rose quartz, tanzanite, sapphire, citrine. I don't know. Rainbow, obsidian, cats. That one's cool. I like that. We actually have a boom, but I like with this boom, it's included, right? Like, anyone does a quest, you work hard enough and you get the quest done, then you absolutely can earn that. And that was one of the other things that makes it nice when you do like finish someone off, like at the end of a round, to have that. And that's something that I wanted. And so we got it, but we also have the pass, so we'll be able to gain like more specialized looking ones. So I'm really, really excited. Like I said, I'm having fun. I'm really hoping that being able to see like how I play with like very limited experience, and just kind of from like a beginner standpoint, like what makes sense and what kind of attracts my attention. Coven, I think, is really, really amazing. Plus, you can make a coven leader as someone that's not those three. And it does seem pretty easy to get all three of them. Probably the hardest one to get is Morgana, but LeBlanc is phenomenal. Lissandra. Lissandra does a great job, but Gragas, I think if you are brand new and you're like, I don't know who to get, Dawnbringer is a really good starting point as well, and Coven. But you just want to make sure you have a good front line. And if you're only going to have one, like me, until mid to late game, Gragas is phenomenal. absolutely phenomenal. Like, I was like, I'm gonna be frontline heavy. Like, yeah, my frontliner was very tanky and very strong, and he did enough to where my backline and my assassins could pretty much just like tear the teams apart. So, not too shabby. A second place win for not knowing what in the world we're doing. So we're just kind of, like I said, the whole purpose of this, like, while we're in an experimental phase, right? So we're experimenting with the different classes, kind of learning them and like going through the highs and lows with it. And then once we kind of get a good understanding and a good feel of how to build with each of these different classes, then that's when we're going to start dipping into rank. And our goal, like I mentioned in the previous video, is to get gold. The highest I've ever been on TFT is silver, but I've only pursued rank games once. So I just want to kind of go through the experimental phase and give you like a better insight to see like, oh, if you haven't played TFT, you don't know who these champions are. You're able to kind of see like from someone who's going through it, kind of like what works, what doesn't work, and then being able to kind of take that and run with it and kind of apply anything that I am able to help with, I'm definitely here for it. I think the one other thing that I have to work on, which is my learning curve as well, is formation strategy. Like, I don't know what works, what doesn't work quite yet. I know, like with assassins, either on the outside, middle, it really all kind of just depends. So I think for me, I want to, kind of play around with formation strategies and see what works and what doesn't work, because I know that can make a huge difference as well. But thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you found value in kind of this deeper insight into more of the Dawnbringer with the Dash of Assassins, but mainly highlighting how valuable the Coven class is and how impacting they can be on your team, especially if you're like, I don't know how I'm gonna do this, or if you're able to get all three of them, grab them and then, you know, let them power up someone else, right? So it doesn't have to be Morgana, Lissandra, or LeBlanc that gets powered up. It can be another legend or another champion, which I think is actually pretty amazing that they give that as an option or a feature. But like I said, with that being said, thank you guys so much. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed the content. Make sure to subscribe to the channel, which you probably already did. I know you did. Thank you for doing that. I appreciate it. Don't forget to also hit that bell to be notified when the next video goes live. And I'll see you guys next time in the clouds. See ya.